an absolute nail biter to kick off our Swedish derby. But in the end, the Ninjas would be the ones to claw it across the finish line on overpass. 16-12 to NIP, and with that, a foot in front of their Swedish counterparts heading into Inferno. Joining me to crack this open, this regional rivalry, my lovely analysts, Potter and Blair. And Blair, such a close map, including that first half, but particularly impressive to see NIP being able to put some more key rounds on the board, considering what we saw of them against FaZe, and that Fnatic had a very good start here.
Yeah, Fnatic actually had a very good start. I really like what they did. Their anti-ecos were clean initially. That's one thing I had a problem with, right? They weren't winning pistols and whatnot. Everything was going good. And then to lose, the first two rounds they lose to NIP are to pistols, right? They got taken down. But Tech9's are set up in the bathrooms area. Not ideal. When you know that Tech9's around, you can get swarmed. And then, yeah, it was a pretty good half overall for NIP. You get 7 rounds on a T-side. It's pretty much done and dusted, right? But Fnatic, that T-side, they tested NIP CT side. We keep talking about Fnatic being very good on the T-side. That's what they showed until round 25. I'm still trying to wrap my head around why, oh why, AJW and Flush are not buying. Okay, fine. They bought pistols. Fine. Why not a MAC-10? You don't want to go for a full investment, a UMP, anything apart from just going for pistols against what was eventually, I think, 4 rifles for the side of NIP. So I feel like that was a little bit of a misread coming out from Fnatic, and that was a round where it all went wrong for the Fnatic side.
Yeah, and perhaps before we sort of talk about that misbuy, I know, Potter, you were saying you thought Fnatic were going to be closing it out there, and there was a good reason why, right?
Yeah, exactly. And it was up until that misbuy that Fnatic were actually looking to swing things, because remember, before, they didn't even buy those pistols. They held on to them in the anti-eco that they won the round before, rather the deco round that they won before. So definitely such a swingy match. And I wanted to actually bring us to the stats, Helix, to show once again yet another deco that Fnatic actually were able to convert. And this is kind of where Fnatic absolutely postured following this round. Take a look at this purchase. Only a smoke and 2 flashbangs to work with, but they absolutely make this work. A smoke down gives Nock a false sense of security. You see here, he's taking a look to see if he can help Rez out. Not a lot of jump spotting here for Nock, and it really catches him off guard at the last minute spotting. Oh shoot, this is a pounce. Shooting some pop shots off, but at this point, man, it's just swarmed. All these pistols, the fearlessness in Fnatic coming through strong. And this is the round that Fnatic were able to convert. If we can go to the point of view, Nock here missing. Ah, that's such a crucial shot for him to miss. It did look like he was good for it, probably feeling a little bit robbed there. And because of that miss, the snowball occurs. Twist, blind, caught with the nade out. And that's just how fast these ecos tend to work with Fnatic when they pull the trigger that fast on you. And as I mentioned, after that round, Fnatic, they were able to put 4 in a row on the board, really isolating Nock out of position, flashing him out. He had an AWP in all 4 of those rounds. So definitely in my book, I had Fnatic closing this one out through and through. But once again, that weird wonky buy coming to bite Fnatic in the ass.
Yeah, it was indeed. Of course, NIP are 1 up currently in this series, but Inferno is just around the corner. We're going to see if Fnatic can pull it back after this.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It is Fnatic, it is Ninjas in Pajamas, it is Scrawny, it is Launders, it is Counter-Strike, it is everything we would hope for and more, at least on that first map, man. A back and forth affair that kind of left me in an awkward spot. That weird, you know, double pistol buy type situation, the back and forth force wars that finally stabilized for NIP. I think it is safe to say that that first map could have gone either way for the longest time. And once we got into the waning few moments of it, it was NIP who walked away with their victory. Props to them, not taking anything away. But Fnatic, not nearly out of this yet.
It's always very strange with Fnatic. It feels like a consistent thing where you just can't put your finger on it. Some of their decisions, some of the rounds they win, some of the rounds they lose. It just comes with it, the good and the bad. But now we're on to Inferno, and Fnatic have pretty impressive stats on this map. We'll let the pistol play out, maybe talk about that a bit more when the dust settles. It's a passive setup here from the CTs and the A site. More heavily leaned towards B, flash goes up, and all the footsteps are on. Whoa.
Executed. Twist puts Golden down. Ooh, Brolin answering back. That was at the base of Banana. They got the two players to push down B, and they punished for it. There was nowhere for Fnatic to go, except for thanks to those two kills back the other direction. There is still a couple of ninjas scrambling to get into position. Hoppus, most notably, will have a chance.
It's waiting for a flash, I think. Oh, no, his teammates doesn't even have one.
No, he's the man with the flashbangs. There's the execute from Nock. That could make all of the difference. That one headshot right there. Sure, the bomb plant's going to come through for Fnatic. Now Hoppus could technically start throwing his utility, but he's just going to hold on to it. And Krim's a good chance at the 1v3. He gets it. Two headshots on the three frags, just clotheslining them as they tried to stampede out from spawn.
You take the good and the bad with Fnatic because you get rounds like that, and it's supposed to make up for him in the long run. Okay, well, crazy that we just saw that. He was supposed to die. Very low health on Krims coming into that third kill. Well, so far, Fnatic have played Inferno at Fall for recent statistics 5 times, and they've won 3 of 5. Conversely, NIP are undefeated at DreamHack Fall on Inferno, but they've only played it twice, once versus Sprout and once a couple days ago versus FaZe that we watched. The losses that we see from Fnatic are OG and Astralis. No shame in that. They did absolutely destroy Vitality, who we saw was so good on this map 15-5.
Lofty cleared off of orange boxes. Even Hoppus is going to be sent down low. Deagle kills, perhaps. The damage is there into the second one on Golden, but starting to stack up here. Additional utility. Bomb ticking. Scout scoped. Rez awaits it. It's going to be a tough fight to win on that MP9. They're just looking to maybe do some more damage as that bomb will eventually blow up. They've got the anchor down at the bottom of Banana, so why not? Definitely things worth saving here. That's exactly how this one's going to unfold. They just walk away with the little they have left over. Could have had more kills, clearly, as the HP tells a tale of substantial damage. And Twist, just for a moment, there was like 3 players right there. A wild spray could have gotten him something, but it won't. It's Fnatic with the 2-0. And in our other game, FaZe Clan, wreck and face on Dust 2.
14-11 versus North. 2-0 for Fnatic. We'll buy in. JW scout purchase. Just waiting to see what ends up here for NIP. They've got some armor and some recycled guns. Just what they can. Getting what they can. Full on default here from Fnatic. A little bit of a lean towards B, trying to punish any half wall peek or aggressive banana setup. They'll see nothing. Golden throwing a smoke down front sight on B to cause a disturbance. Hampus is here on the other side of it, though, and he's got his own smoke to counter with. They're hoping, Hampus is hoping he can sell them a bill of goods, send them over to the A site, up into this stack on lane, and it seems like that he might get his wish.
Smoke actually goes beyond Twist. So that's not going to screw him over just yet, but Nock will get spotted. Brolin with the double kill. Now it's the answer back from the ninjas. 3 kills and a potential for an additional as Krims sent reeling back into the app. 40 health to his name. He's dead. And they have done it. They have pushed Flusha into the clutch. He's got no bomb and 30 seconds left. He's coming, sprinting in for it. And he doesn't even grab it as Twist robs the kill back. 3 frags for Twist. Ninjas on the board when they had no business winning. I guess we're right back to where we were on Overpass.
That's a Brolin with the opening too, but this stack is so powerful. We see this work so many times now, you know, and with a number of teams. And, you know, it's partly just because there's so much refrag potential, so many close angles. It almost makes me wish teams just full execute B on these anti-ecos, because you can at least molly out all the spots and know they don't have enough utility to defend. But coming up middle like that can be quite dangerous. Punish again, Nox starts out this round hot. And man, it's not out of the realm of possibility that NIP win this map, as good as Fnatic's recent performances have been on Inferno. We definitely have seen a lot of good out of NIP on this map.
I'm right there with you. I agree. I think this whole series was always just going to be up in the air, regardless of map.
For sure, for sure.
Right from the veto, it was like, nice. We're locking horns. Swedish, yeah. Viking horns.
Yeah, it probably feels like a scrim for them, right? Like friends playing Counter-Strike. We already saw Overpass just look so different from what we saw versus FaZe. Conglomeration of the CTs here at the A site. Bopsky on the inside, but now dead.
Ooh. Brolin getting away with the first one, getting away with further damage, potentially getting away with the CT spawn, but the problem is the bomb carrier is still kind of stuck here on arch side. Had Nox still been holding this, it may have been an issue, but Twist gets aggressive up lane. That's the bomb slain. And you can see Hop is kind of not sure which direction to go over towards that B site. He'll figure it out eventually, but 15 seconds left. Fnatic bomb still now spotted yet again on this side of the map. It's Rez with a swift headshot, just skimming it through the doorway of Library. Barely alive are Rez and Nock, and Krims is coming into the bomb site. 3 seconds to spare, and it's over. As long as Hop is doesn't die, and he won't, it is Ninjas with a second round. But damn, a price tag.
Yeah, I feel like could they not have crunched the A site a little bit sooner than that? Or gone towards a B split after killing Plopsky and spawn? Two decisions that maybe would have led to a different outcome. But hindsight is 20/20, of course. Fnatic dropping on time. And, well, now respond with a force up. It looked like JW had a bit more money than the rest of his comrades. Up to the op. Will CTs expect this?
Roasted. Ooh, and JW roasted. Vying for banana control. They're going to put a lot of rounds down range. Fire now, though. However, just on the other side, and Hoppus, he's got nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide. As that smoke fades, Hoppus doesn't need to hide. The deagle for the three-piece. 4 kills in total. Oh, we all just get lost in those eyes.
Wasn't that spectacular? Quite a hold here.
To him, man.
Some great utility usage to get JW out of the round right away. Maybe they didn't anticipate finding an op on a round like that, but they'll be happy to see that he was hand over face. We need more. Nip and Fnatic have played on Inferno 24 times in CSGO, but we've only seen OT once. Oh, wow. That's surprising. That's so surprising. It's only gotten to that.
I would like more.
Yeah, that tie, why not? Oops. Hey, maybe today's a new day.
Every day is a new day. Technically.
Very true. Yeah. Oh, Fnatic.
I mean, what you will.
NIP, don't change much. You know, that worked out well.
Ooh, 4
HE grenades and 2 flashbangs for Crimsicle.
I feel like these 4 grenades, they just have Hompus' name written all over them.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, you think so?
They all just say revenge on them.
Yeah. Crimson's got the flashes for it.
Oh,
flash high and then artillery strike. They backed up. There's one.
Oh, and his grenade does more.
Oh, that's just sick. Ooh. And twisted. Hampus, 3 kills. He could go on, and he will. Another 4K. As many frags as they had frags. God damn.
He's like pulling out the Vinny performance. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, Hampus, it's not that he's a bad player. In fact, he plays a very, like, on the overpass when he's rotating a CT. He does such a great job helping out with A, and definitely can be overlooked, but he is farming right now on Banana, and we know that that's just where a majority of frags can come from. So scary scenes for Fnatic as NIP go up 4-2, losing very little.
Couple kills back for Fnatic, man advantage.
They're not in a terrible spot though, actually, because Fnatic decided to peel back. Nox got the op in Halls, and they have bottom B control with a rotator on Arch, and now a kill. Fnatic's position becomes worse suddenly. If they continued on with A a little bit more quickly, it would have been in a fine spot. They didn't know exactly how much control NIP had. Flash. Awkward. Very awkward. This is the right play for Nock. He's going to go and try to clear out lane, but now they're moving fast towards B. Pressure on Flopsky. He's going to try to get the quad, but they've already crossed.
Oh my god, they line up. The spray that could have been. The clutch that could be. Nock's going to move his feet up Banana. Looking to make the play happen here. They don't know which way he's coming from, but for now, Fnatic are separate. Ooh, and there's two sides to this smoke. He's going to walk right through it. Krims honed in on him, able to close. Fnatic with a third, using that CT spawn B wraparound to best Plopsky and close that gap. Just a one-round lead for the Ninjas.
Nicely done. I like the all the moves. Oh my god, North. It was 14-11 for FaZe Clan. North are up 15-14 now. What happened here?
Oh,
that okay.
Overtime.
Oh, we go to OT. Wow, okay.
That's why you've got two monitors, folks.
True. One eye each.
Oh, careful.
Nock aggressive opening versus a rifle. Ouch. He spots one. Whoa, he shoots Flusha through the floor, I think. Floor bang for Nock. I like how Fnatic adjusted there, even though things got sketchy. But I also like how NIP tried to come back to top mid with a flash for Hompus to get a kill. It's hard to say that was a bad play, but I think everybody at the same time from Fnatic was clearing Arch, so they were also playing anti-flash incidentally.
How many does Nock bag here?
He's gonna get flashed off for sure.
Jumps in. Oh, doesn't quite get into cover fast enough. Twist off the balcony, looking to pick up those pieces, falling into the small pit. Can't quite control the spray down. And for that reason, we've got a round now. For Fnatic, we are tied up at 4 apiece. Ninjas starting to get flexed on as this T-side's coming into its own.
Yeah, Nock takes an enormous risk trying to stay flashed to look for a timing shot. Better off to just take the shot and fall back just so at least you get to cover. Maybe you get the shot in. About the same odds as if you, you know, wait blind for it. But didn't want to have to get full executed on. Was in a per. And Fnatic will go ahead, pull that one out. Let's see why they are so scary.
Rolling. Look at this. Easy as ever, man. You know, Nock had a chance to maybe get into the bomb site. Maybe thought he had a couple seconds more so, but no. Denied. First call for a timeout from the Ninjas. Time to collect their thoughts. Who needs to step up here, man? We've got 11 kills. And I want to say Hompus.
Yeah. I mean, Hompus doing great on... There's just... I think it's small decisions here. I mean, I don't want to put it to the frags just quite, but there's a lot of rotations that I think are resulting in the rounds being won. Fnatic, you know, lost a weird round where they ran out of time trying to wrap Arch into the site. NIP made some good adjustments. I think Nock made a mistake there, hanging out a bit too long in the flashbang last round specifically, you know, a reason why they may have lost. So I think it's decisions that are dictating the rounds.
Aggression, quick pace, and then silence. Get that smoke over top towards Coffins. I wonder if ninjas make much of a move here. You see a floater in Hompus. One of the two rifles, maybe trying to get closer to this site. Ouch. It's tough to get out of that position once the molly's burning. You can see the effects of it. 70 damage versus Plopsky. As the only M4 in position on this B site, that's not where he wants to be. Now they're going to commit to this. Hoppus could get over in time. Twist with the Deagle. Good enough to slow it down, but he burns. And Hoppus so blinded that he never even thought to put shots through smoke. Brolin over the side of it, making the most of a slight gap. And now putting Fnatic in the lead. 5 rounds to their T side already, and way more work to do.
Okay. Dead into spawn. Bottom banana looking for what he can get. And yeah, Fnatic now officially in the lead. So we'll get the reset. You know, the way Fnatic are working the map, it's quite fast. It's demanding from NIP, but I don't think it's a surprise. I feel like NIP have half a mind of what to expect. But it's one of those things that everyone's got to plan until they get hit. And that's really the Fnatic effect. It's the same thing NA teams tell themselves about Furia. And then, you know, you actually have to go up against it. They're a hard team to practice against because they've got a unique playstyle. But as Twist said, they are counterable, very much so. Probably all comes with experience. Knock. He spots this one. That should be free, but he drops the shot and will change to the no-scope. Oh. But he can't put that together. There's another opening for Brolin. Maybe two. No res. Will refrag. Not only refrag, but double up.
Yep, Crims then. He doubles down. Slides out from balcony. Rex face. Brolin being able to jump into the side of Arch to dodge Rez's first attempt. Still, he got 2 kills there. Bomb has been planted. But Crims really making the most of the moment, slipping out from balcony. Knowing the site was a little flustered. Hompus and Plopsky.
You know, Knock is not... Okay, hold on a second.
Another.
Wow, imagine he got that one. Smoke down, big pit, flash to slow him down.
Molly on bomb, though. That's what JW is waiting for. And a Molly on bomb would spell disaster for the ninjas in pajamas. He's trying to get out of here at this point, trying to flee, trying to run. And he's not going to get away. Not at all. Fnatic, a 6th round on the board. JW survives it. That's 12 kills for Crimson Brolin. And those two players alone are what cracked open this A site.
Really nicely done from Crims.
Ooh.
Yeah, just a multi-pronged assault. But you know what? Knock, I mean, you know what? Knock had over 20 kills on Overpass, but he was dropping some key ones, right? And here on... Inferno, he's having some struggles as well with the op. It's really been his team has actually tried to make up for a lot of the shots that he's missed. I mean, he has had some great rounds too, but still. Doesn't cancel out the mistakes.
You are not forgiven. Ooh, dangerous peek down middle, Hompus. The solo scout is caught by Crims. One does not simply poke the bear and walk away. Roland's going to eat the flashbang. Twist convinced not to follow up on the peak, and all of the pressure falls on to Plopsky. A CZ versus 4 Ts. Rez actually has a little gap in the smoke. Good enough for a second frag. Hey now.
Oh my god.
A third. Brolin, however, back in middle. It's the bomb carrier on his own. Rez, he wants to chase this, but they go for the boost, and that's going to give JW his exit route. Now, ninjas scrambling back to the other side of the map, but I don't think Rez can get in time. Not with Brolin already sectioning off library like this.
This is weird. I mean, he can spot JW, has to cross this to get onto the site, so that's info at least, but JW will just win. Now, yeah. Knock might be aware of this. He might. But maybe not.
Nope.
Oh boy, he's
butterfly effect. Slash and dash from little boy Brolin. 7th round for Fnatic. I say little boy Brolin, but he plays that one like a man. Dude, cutting off the spawn.
They're throwing this smoke wrong on purpose. What's going on?
Yeah, that's not the first time, right?
Time number
two. Right, and to be fair, the first time around, I believe somebody from Fnatic was using it. Like, they looked around the side. Yeah. They caught the CT player kind of walking by it. This time, it gets exploited on the other end. What goes around comes around, they say.
Some Yogi, probably.
Later, Plopsky.
And fire at logs. Plopsky's a marshmallow.
Singed. Fnatic absolutely taking control of this T side. Make a nip work for every inch. Every centimeter.
Okay. There's one man who can stop him. It's this guy right here.
But one guy is the emphasis there. Completely alone. Has knock moving over, but that smoke's going to nullify the op. Frag grenade does zero damage because of the corner of the wall. Knock takes damage, and that's going to convince them to save. That right there is enough to recall from the action. An eighth round for Fnatic, doubling up the score of Nip and showing no signs of slowing down on this excellent T side of Inferno.
Yeah, surprised to see they set up that way with, I don't know, like, I guess they were set up to save if it was going to be a B hit. It had to be the protocol right out the gate, but I feel they had a chance of winning if they played Hompus in the side. I guess he was just, you know, susceptible to getting hit by a Molotov, naded out, that kind of thing. So they decided to play it safe. Fnatic call it out. Well, the save looks ironclad at least, but it's 8-4 now for Fnatic. And OT is getting spicy. FaZe looking for 18. And Lekro, whoa, he's trying to deny that.
You said Lekro, what the? Lekro. I got flashbacks. I was like, wait, what? Ninjas? No.
NIP.
North? Who? Fnatic? Which team is he playing on? Fun fact, 2005. Brolin and Plopsky were 3 years old when the first Nip versus Fnatic game was played.
That's nuts. Yeah, Plopsky had that really endearing interview. It was a DreamHack, wasn't it? DreamHack Masters Malmo, I think. I actually can't remember exactly what event it was. But he talked about showing up to cheer for NIP.
Yep.
And then a year or two later ended up being on the team.
Yep.
The stories that make you love esports. Things like that being possible.
From rags to riches.
And the CT timeout is worn off. It's a headphone off pause. Remember, they've been doing that consistently. Makes everyone just kind of communicating in real life, letting them know it's half virtual, half LAN.
Here we have it. A little aggression. Okay, I like this. I like this. Off of the pause, they try to throw res into the mix. And already establishing the opening kill versus Brolin. He's trying to flash his way out of this. He sets himself up, but Krims with his 14th kill of the map brings it back to the 4v4.
So the flash was perfect too. Krims was full white, right? How the hell did he even win that? He must have just pre-fired the corner. Sprayed and prayed. His teammate said, you got that. And this is where Nock comes in. I'm really curious to see how this goes this time. Bit more of a passive look, maybe anticipating some kind of similar A exec to the one that got him killed last time, falling back, relying on Twist to help him out here versus Halls. Smoke comes down just in time. No execute is called. Interesting. They still seem to want to continue on with this, though.
Fnatic have done a good job of just kind of pushing right through. Off of the flash, they'll go. It's Twist with the hold initially. Sees a couple players up in balcony. Molly rains down in on him. He has teammates to try and help, and the second is above him, but his gun is actually dry. Flush out and Crims, all that's left. It's a 2v2, 20 seconds. And Knock on the bomb site, has to hit the shot. He drops the first one. Now the pressure's on. A second bullet goes astray, but luckily Plopsky saves the day and Crims is left in pit here. He has the bomb. He needs the shot to get out. Needs to alleviate the pressure and close this distance. Starts to exit, tapping at the man in the back. He just can't manage. Ninjas take a fifth.
I talked too much about Plopsky. He cannot hit a shot. And we're looking for... Wait, is that another overtime? No, that's FaZe ending up winning, finally. Oh, almost the upset for North. Would have been a major one.
But FaZe, I didn't notice another that was map 1, 2, or 3, though.
Yeah, I don't know.
Did you cap?
Draft. Not sure.
I need to know. But we also still have tantalizing action back on your screens right here with Nip and Fnatic. There's more Swedes in this server, so it must be better CS.
Back's
no golden point. Down to a quarter.
And if Plopsky lost his duel there, Nock was in trouble, man. I've been talking about Nock so much, he hasn't hit a damn shot on the A site.
Yeah, what's going on with that?
I don't know.
I feel like lane, it's not...
Switch your sense. That's what he needs to do.
Faster or slower?
Actually, he's playing on simple sensitivity. Oh my god. Will this be simple? Yep. Plopsky. All of it
looking
to do.
Easy.
Office dies in the back.
He's going for the second. Nails it. Player going to the top side. JW right in front of it. Plopsky doing enough damage to nearly get the third, but Rez through smoke denies JW any further footing. Crim sliding out as the headshot connects thanks to Rez. He is trying to save the day, but it's rolling in the clutch. 1v3 with a sniper creeping inwards. He's going to walk into it, and that is that. A sixth round for Nip as they come through with the defuse. Now, they are going to be trailing by the time they start their T side. But closing this half 8-7, leaving it split down the middle just like Overpass, would really just be indicative of what this series has been. A nail-biting back-and-forth affair. Plopsky looked like he was playing scared, and then he comes out swinging with the 2K. A lot of damage on the follow-up, which really enabled Rez to get his second frag. And suddenly, as said, Nip within one. Well, within two. One assuming they close this half with yet another round win.
Just like on Overpass, Fnatic, they lean T on Inferno as well. So, be a narrow margin, honestly. I think if NIP gets 7, they'll be happy. Knock drops another one.
Nice.
Okay.
That
take both sides.
Crims update. 16-7.
Damn. Oh my god, Rez is about to get shot on the side. How did he not see that? Golden.
Whoop.
Very confusing. Not sure what happened there. Just Twist.
Gets baited out by the jump. And he will get the kill, sure enough, but the trade frags are all there for him. Wouldn't want to be in Nox's shoes. Bit of a cooler situation for him here on Inferno. 1v3 here to close out the half. Let's be real, Fnatic, looking like they've got that 3-round lead, the 9 T rounds to the scoreboard on their map choice. Close at times. Couldn't be further. In others, Knock burned into the open. He is done for. Sure enough, it's Crims to get his 17th kill, keeping the ADR above 100. Join us after the halftime break to see who closes on Inferno. We'll be right back.
I'm standing in the corner watching the punches fly as the tears keep rolling down my eyes. I keep on moving, holding my hands up high, fighting through the minutes, through my life. Your comments are mean, but I take it easy. Your talking is cheap, you don't seem to know.
Fnatic made the ninjas sweat all across the second half of Overpass, and now it's the ninjas in the hot seat. Let's see if they can do what was done to them and cause a few waves here as they take to the T side of Fnatic's map choice. Fnatic looking good across the first 15, most notably Crimson Brolin. What is the solution if there is one? Crim's going to be challenged and just instantly bested. The CZ rattles off. Empty-handed, Hompus, 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 says the kill feed. Flush on Golden, nowhere to be found.
Hompus, Hompus, Hompus. Holy hell. I mean, I guess it's not just the CT side. It wasn't just easy spray downs. He's really feeling it today. It's a pretty impactful 3K to get here on the second pistol. Looking to tie things up. I'll have to fight through a couple of anti-ecos, but that's a strong start. What more is there to say? Hompus, Hompus, Hompus just ran up onto the A site. I mean, there's no stopping him.
I don't know, man.
No, I loved it. God. I think that really encapsulated the exact
Did
feeling.
It? Yeah. Okay. If that's how you had to Hompus, summarize Hompus, this round.
Ooh. I mean, if you had any other name, it wouldn't have twist, twist, twist. You know, it has to be Hompus, 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 but no, it's perfect.
Just running in, clamping down on him, man. They didn't even have a chance. Two guys up on balcony. What are you doing up there with the CZ?
Yeah.
Deagle's up. Grenades in tow. It's a flex contest on Banana. Everybody's throwing grenades, but like flexing, doesn't really do much. 5 damage on Flush Up. That's about it.
Well,
Roland.
They're getting shoved into lane, but lane's actually the prime choke point to hit. Rotations are here from the CTs. Bomb is holding back for the flank. That's a dangerous spot for the bomb. This is King Crab fishing in Counter-Strike. They're going to go back to Rez, or what's going on? I feel like they're asking to get picked apart here with the way they're playing this round.
Oi, there's Plopsky. He's actually going to take quite a bit of damage in his engagement. Knock will bring it back. There's the A opening, and there's the bomb. Golden this whole time. He was thinking about going down mid, was turned back because of that presence, and well, he'll just be all alone as this one comes to a close. So the Ninjas straight into the T side, able to close that lead to just a measly one round difference. Who do your eyes fall upon if I ask you to name the player from NIP that could turn this map around?
There's actually three players. Hompus, Hompus, Hompus.
I'm never going to hear the end of that. Oh. Sometimes I feel like two people, you know? Sometimes I can't keep up. Things just come out. It's organic. It's natural.
You are a human soundboard.
Working on it.
Golden's hair is just chilling.
What about Crims?
Took all of Crims' hair.
Where are they? What is this room?
I want to know more about what's in the room, yeah.
Is that a sauna?
We need some Fnatic room lore.
Deep. In the woods of Sweden.
Ooh, this is a, well, that's a big power play. Of course, it's just pistols they're going up against, but first kill. Oh, that takes the edge off. Let's take both sides at once. Why not? Here's the MAC-10s.
Come on, JW, do something crafty. Ooh.
I don't even know where they got shot from. Oh my God.
Oh, oh, it's such a robbery, man. Knock goes from like 20 HP to 4. Can't you just round down in instances like that? Seems not. Ninjas, they are going to tie 9 rounds apiece, but this is what we're waiting for. Fnatic with the purchase. Time to stop the bleeding, boys.
Opening strategy here for NIP. Chance to really lay down the hurt. 4 rounds in a row coming out of the last. All right, 3 rounds in a row coming into the second half. Opening kill though to Flusher this time around. Just got the better of him, but that was rifle versus pistol.
Molly holds it back, but they still exit from Boiler, actually. JW jumping out of danger's way. Plopsky playing the counter flash, and that flash does pop right in the eyes of Twist. He was thinking about toying with the corner, but JW coming in. Good damage output. Damn, man. Hits Plopsky onto 31 HP. He's going through it. Or at least he tried to. Doesn't quite work out for him. That's a bit of a frag gifted back to Plopsky, but they're going to, continue in on this. Crims, he's chilling in the little pit. Hoppus falling down upon him and sent packing as Crims does further damage. It's a 2K between both Plopsky and Nock. Leaves Golden to clutch. Rounds the first corner. Nock's caught running. Not the mistake to make. Plopsky.
He's in a good spot, though. Plopsky's
trying to fixate this. Golden trying to clear all the corners, has no clue where he's gotten off to, doesn't see the peak coming, and sure enough, Plopsky is the close. Ninjas have a lead.
Something so strong about being on the opposite side of the default, walking up the wall to fight them on lane there. So they're trying to break open this crossfire, thinking about pit in sight. So many windows of timing to push in and get the kill. Well played by Plopsky, and man, does JW throw that one away? I mean, you don't necessarily win because you have a man advantage, but in that situation, they were doing really good, but I guess JW underestimated the amount of damage he actually put through that smoke. Now they're back on the pistols.
Ooh. Couple frags down to the base of mid. Lopsky worse for wear. Pistol's getting dangerously close. They actually run back. Now, if they go all the way over and stack this A site, I'm going to be a big fan of the play. Here we get that execute from Nip. We've seen some nice executes from them on Inferno. Fast ones on the half buys and more tempered aggression in rounds like this. Crims. There's the Deagle onto the bomb carrier. Check out this kill feed. It's all pistol frags coming out for Fnatic. It's flawless. They're able to move those B players into position fast enough. Twist, 1v5 dies. Fnatic ties 10 rounds apiece.
Wild as they just seem so comfortable to specifically stand behind smokes to do damage. Crims does work here. Oh man, shuts them down on lane in front of their smoke. JW wraps around to library, spams through, grabs a kill, misses his first round of bullets, gets the second. And so it was map one for FaZe that we saw. Now it's a 1-1 situation with, I guess, a force up one here for Northy. Okay, 10 to 10 on this map. Things started to heat up just like they did on Overpass. Happens to start on a pistoling round. Everyone buying up. Any concessions? It looks like Twist only has a MAC-10. And there's one player without head armor, but sometimes this MAC-10 can be better than the AK despite the head armor for the mobility.
Respect my mobility. Bobski, easy opener. Tries to dunk the nade down, but that one misses the mark. Golden has to run through fire. Well, doesn't has to, but decides to.
Oh, this is where they potentially rotate. They got three stacked towards B. A site getting hit right now. Brolin throws in a Molly on Arch, which is interesting. You wouldn't think the lone man would do that. So it kind of like duplicates his presence. And they flank mid.
Roland's in the playmaker position. He knows they're already outwards. Ooh, gets the guy off balcony first, but yeah, there's the Hampus play. However, the Hampus trade back by JW, 2v2. Plopsky still standing up in the open. Bomb yet to cross over, has to fight with the MAC-10 versus the man on lane. Fire blanketing everything at this point. And a frag grenade that just chips away at Plopsky ever so barely. Now here he is, planting the bomb. 1v2, he's got health over top of them. Peeks out, hits the headshot, and the second. JW goes down, Plopsky with the 4K, never even blinks.
Plopsky with the madness. He pulls off the 1v2 to win Overpass. And then he puts up three on this round. Four with the 1v2. And I think he read this properly. Like, he entertained the idea that they might have doubled back on lane. But I think in his mind, he really did believe they were going to Arch. I mean, he was so prepared for that second frag. That was pretty sick, man. That was pretty sick. Uh-oh.
Wasting no time. Ah, Rez, you're still burning.
He's got other problems.
There's the trade. Good enough by Plopsky. Gets the job done. Two dozen grenades later.
They're going to fight Banana. They know they have to get these smoke kills, these rush kills.
Yeah, Banana kind of gets messy sometimes. W fixated, misses the shot. Knock down, flusha, back sight.
Weird.
Awkward. Volley goes deep, but already at this point, the man's gotten away and Hoppus doesn't have his bomb. Gonna have to go get that. Oi! And he never even has the chance. The op connecting for three from JW.
Such an easy round for JW. I mean, this one's forgivable because he might be trying to go for some kind of walk-up, but no CT smoke. Wouldn't guess that he'd miss that one on Twist. That was a little bit risky to leave spawn open trying to hit the B site that way. And that's going one for one in those opening kills. So yeah, pretty easy round for JW. Right place, right time for the first one. The rest is standard practice. And now it's back to pistols here for NIP. 11 to 11, make a wish. What'd you wish for?
Can't tell you. Won't come true.
Overtime.
Maybe we get there. Hell, we had so many moments within that first map where rounds were tied. So much back and forth that I think we're getting there. Mm-hmm. More importantly than overtime, I don't want this to just fizzle out. I don't want either of these teams to just break through with momentum. It's been back and forth all series. More of that, please. Getting ready for the pop. Smoke laid down, further utility out in mid. This is two guys' apartments, three middle. Damage being output from the pit. The frag grenade's fantastic, and JW is actually sectioned off from the situation.
Whoa.
He's got a smidgen of a gap, but he doesn't quite take the shot. Oh, dunked on. Crims off the backboard. Or rather, skybox. Now, because of that, it's actually a man advantage. Not to mention, you take into the equation the fact that the CTs have guns. They're all in on lane. This could cause a bit of an awkward fight with Twist on the AUG. Hompus kind of peering downwards, now smoked out of the situation. This does leave knock on the site. AUG trying to get into the mix. Twist will find one headshot. Here's Hompus, unable to land anything at this point. And the player's so damn close, not to mention the defuse coming through. 12 rounds for Fnatic.
Hard one to earn. Twist, nice flick up from that position and pit to get the first frag. But everybody else deals with everything else. Especially Golden. Both down in pit on his watch. And NIP lose another. It was close. They get the bomb plant. A little bit scary to get the moto smoke out. And there's no CTs within the site to fight. But the retake works out nicely. Pistols again for NIP.
Quick opener. Not that this round should get you too excited. Not with the unarmored pistols. Where to go, what to do, and when to do it.
Does Twist have a pistol? Because he looks like he wants one.
Yeah. There it is.
Okay.
You know, they like lawyers, they provide those for free. Flash in front of the pit. Gonna stop that right in its tracks. Stopped it before it even had a chance to get going. Here comes Hompus, deagle in hand. And down by Golden as Fnatic add a 13th to the tally. His 3K here versus the unarmored pistol players puts him to 16 frags. Pulling away from JW ever so slightly. But, I mean, nobody's getting close to Crims. 22 and 12 at the top of the CT scoreboard. Where do our eyes fall for Ninjas? Well, it's tied between Hompus and Plopsky. Where is Nock?
He doesn't seem to have joined the server quite yet. He doesn't seem to get shaken up in moments like that. We'll still see a great rounder here or there. I think it was really the op that was off for some reason. But I think he does a lot, op or not. I think he's what I would call extremely complete because of his positioning, because of his nade usage, all the other things as well. So sure to create value no matter what happens. But yeah, they're not gonna pull off an upset victory on Inferno without him. Oh, interesting. Flesher does not drop that incendiary. And if you don't go through the smoke.
They're getting corralled back to the CT stack.
Wow.
Twist. Oh my god, dude. This is so risky. There's three players right there on his right.
Let's see if Flush is, you know, disciplined with that Molotov effect things.
How does he get the deepest peek first? Flush's Molly now goes down as he connects the second op shot, a third through Coffins. Absurd play coming out of Flush. Now Hompus looking to save the day. One kill to his name and a bomb on his back. 20 seconds. Goes for the commitment. Golden's going to rush him. That is it. A 14th one for Fnatic. Flush, what a solo hold.
Insane. He can handle it. That was sick. I'm shocked they didn't go through the smoke at first. He kept the incendiary for this play. Drops it down, separates the frags, finds Plopsky. Headshot through the coffins. Not get in the coffin. Fnatic up to 14. And it's four rounds in a row here on CT side. Put NIP back on pistols. Potential for Vertigo.
Yes, please. Oh, yes, please. Give me these teams on Vertigo. Just the thought of Fnatic shenanigans. Nip magic sprinkled on it. Ooh. Just more of this matchup, really. We don't get enough of the head-to-heads. Come on, Flush it. Nice. Doesn't get the first one, but rather the second. Golden's going to get dinked in the process. Flush a burning knock alive.
Oh my God. Since when can you op, man?
Oi. Sure. Hompus will Tech-9 him down, but you can't stop the impact that he's already had. You can't deny the legacy of Flush's 26th round here. And the fact that he's coming hot off of that 3K in the last one. Hop is going to plant safely behind the fountain, behind that temporary cover. There's a chance at this. He's got the first CT sectioned off. Nice first kill, but he backs up a little bit too much. That costs him way too much HP. He sticks his derriere around the side of the Xbox, and because of it, it's a 15th round for Fnatic.
He looked like he had it in him. That was very swift on the first shot, but that's a match point now, and Fnatic don't look like they're going to slow down. They've been great on B, especially Flusha. He's been locking it down. Insane shots, man. Insane. Super fast. Sometimes I look at Flusha and I'm like, this guy is dead inside. But then you see shots like that. Like, man, he is very much alive.
It's beneath
doesn't
the
even
surface.
Flinch. Yeah.
He's got to keep the monster chained up. Oh, they see the barrel. Nothing they can do about it. But Nock knows that Fnatic are at least getting adventurous. Looking to close it. Four map points here. Ooh, Twist with a headshot, though. Okay, man advantage ninjas. Good luck. He flashed it the first time, didn't the second. And JW only posted up once he had already heard the pop. JW back into position, dives into the bomb site, will get away safely. This does open up arch pressure somewhat. Everybody here for both teams, however. It's Golden at bat versus two. Lays down the flash. Now it's Flusha running out from the arch smoke, trying to give chase and doing so successfully. Nock's able to answer with an op kill of his own, but Golden's going to continue on this adventure down mid with a double kill. And Hompus trying to exit from apartments in a one versus three. He is removed. And just like that, Fnatic take the second map and push the series to Vertigo.
Now I'm looking forward to it. We didn't see the upset today, but that just shows, you know, Fnatic are still here to play. We didn't see it on Overpass. Things went slightly awry, but on Inferno, they looked very tough. Hard to read. We had to take it round by round, but no surprise there that Fnatic were able to close it out in the end.
Going to the break. See you guys after the desk for map number three.